Hi guys, in this video I'm going to show you how you can display an image behind your text in Elementor. It only takes a couple of minutes to do, so sit back, relax, hit that like and subscribe button, and let's get into the video. Okay guys, the first thing we're going to do is add a new section to our page. And within that section, we're going to click on the menu icon and drag in a heading widget. And in that heading widget, we're going to set our title as Marvel. This can obviously be anything you want it to be. Now I'm going to click on the style tab in the top left-hand side and click on typography. And the first thing I'm going to do is select our font type. I'm next going to change the size of our font, and I can do that by sliding the slide bar to the very end. With that done, I'm now going to select the Advanced tab in the top left hand side. And once in the Advanced tab, we're going to go down to the bottom where it says Custom CSS. To use custom CSS within Elementor, you will need Elementor Pro. If you don't have Elementor Pro, there is a link in the top of the description. You'll now need to go over to my website, and the link for that is in the description below. And you're going to have to copy this bit of code and paste it in on the left-hand side in the custom CSS box. Now that our code's been added, we're going to add our CSS class name. And for this bit of code, it's heading. So what I'm going to quickly do is highlight the word heading in the top of our code, and I'm going to copy it, and I'm going to go to layout in the top left-hand side and paste it into CSS classes. With our CSS class added, you can see the image behind our text. If you want to change this image, you'll have to go back into the Advanced tab in the top left-hand side and select Custom CSS. As you can see in our code, on the third line down, it says background URL, and it's this URL that you'll need to change. All you need to do is highlight this URL and paste in your new one. You can find your image URL within your WordPress media library. The next thing you'll need to change is your image size. As you can see, it's currently set at 40, and if I increase this, you can see it becomes bigger and closer. Below that is our background repeat. I currently have this image set as no repeat, and if you want to change that, all you have to do is remove the no from the no repeat. To simply explain what no repeat means, it's when one image ends and another one is repeated next to it. Below our image repeat is our background X and Y positioning. As you can see within this background image, our X axis is set to left. You can also change this to center or right. Below that is our Y axis, and this is what sets our image from top, middle and bottom. This makes sure that our image is exactly in the position we want it. Next down in our code is our background color. As you can see, this is currently set as white, and you can change this to any color you like, for example green. If we'd have had our background set as repeat, the green section would have been another image of Spider-Man. If you wanted to use this code multiple times through your web page, all you'd need to do is change your CSS class name. And I'm quickly going to show you how to do that now. And I can do that by right clicking on our section and selecting duplicate. In our second section, I'm going to highlight the text and make sure I go into the Advanced tab of the heading. Within the layout of our Advanced tab, I'm going to change our CSS classes to Heading 1. Now what I need to do is go down to Custom CSS, and where it says Heading, I'm going to change that to Heading 1. Now what I can do is go into our WordPress media library and copy the image URL and replace our Spider-Man image URL with our new Iron Man one. As I said earlier on, all I need to do is highlight the URL and paste in the new one. As you can see, our background image changes instantly. Now all we need to do is change our background size and change its positioning with its X and Y axis. Once you've got it into the position you want it, you'll then need to go to the preview button in the bottom left-hand side next to the publish button. Once in the preview page, you can see whether you need to make any further changes in the positioning of your background images. If you're happy where everything is, all that's left to do is click on the publish button within Elementor. If you have found this video useful so far, please do hit that like and subscribe button. Remember, if you do want to add custom CSS code to your Elementor website, you will need Elementor Pro. If you haven't already got Elementor Pro, there is a link in the top of the description. It is an affiliate link, it doesn't cost you any more to use, but it does give me a very small percentage of Elementor's profits if you choose to sign up. If you have got any questions, feel free to come and drop them in the comments box below. Don't forget to check out the rest of my playlists. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.